This conference will now be recorded.
I-71, right? So Vega BRPC, whenever you install Vega, I'm talking about home version. When you install home version of Vega BRPC, you will be getting Java JDK installed and the required jar files, var file, that is PR web. Here you can see in the URL, this is the var file that gets deployed onto the application server. Your application server here, Tomcat, which also has been automatically installed. After your installation process completed, you would have seen Tomcat server starting up. So there is a command prompt that runs, and after the completion of the Tomcat server comes up, it is going to display your login screen automatically. So that was what happened. And apart from that, it has also installed database environment, and the tables have been automatically created, database created, tables created, and some of the tables have been loaded with some data also. Okay. And this and all happened, which we can see while installation process. And after your installation is completed, I have asked you to go through DB configuration. So the database which is created, if you want to access the database and see what are the tables available in the database and all, you need to do a configuration from the client called PG Postgres SQL client is there. PG admin 4, this is a client. So you, from this client, you should be able to see what is there in the database when you make that connection. To make the connections, I have provided a document. So in the document, you need to create server. I think you have to go ahead and make a connection to the existing database server where I have given you complete steps. Just let me open again. If you are getting like white color screen like this, just close it and open again. No worries. But in enterprise version of application, see your Java JDK will be installed on one server, and Java JDK and Tomcat application servers will be there on one of the application server where you have Pega var file, PR web will be installed. Database will be there on another server. Connections will be manually made, JNDA connections and all. That and all is not your work, that is the work of admins. So we are not required to much bother about this installation process and all in enterprise version. Admins are going to do that in general. See now, this is the navigation to access Postgres database, which has been automatically created when you install Vega. Okay. And now if you go ahead here, schemas. So we need to bother about two schemas. So the first one, data, which you would have accessed in order to see your work tables and all. So data schema, and the second one we need to talk about is rules schema. Okay. So rule schema is the one where business rules will get stored. When I say rule, what do you mean by rule? Rule is anything that you create in Vega. It is property, section, flow action, flows, classes, rule set is also one of the rule. And what else? Page property, that is property. And when condition, when rules. All these are rules. The rules which you create here in PRPC environment will get stored into backend, into tables under rule schema. So now Pega is coming up with two schemas. One is data schema and second one is rules schema. So these are rules. Just for your information as of now, data again I'll tell you later. Now, if you click on Hano Hanover V work, which we have created, this is class. And what are these? The results that are being displayed. These are work objects. These are instances of class group. This is data. This is data. And what about this class? Hano Hanover V work. Class is a rule. Property is a rule. Section is a rule. Flow is a rule. Okay, we have two parts now. That is, one is rules, other one is data. This is data part. So now these are called instances in general. These are called data instances. I'll tell you more about data instances again later. Okay, but as of now, so these are all rules, whatever that you have created so far, and data will be there. So this is data. See, data will be stored into tables of data schema. Data schema is going to have tables and data in it. So this is where we have our work table. Work table, what will be there in work table? What will be there inside work table? This is our object that we have created will get stored into work table. So any work object that you create, that is not a rule. Work object is data part. Okay, your transactional data. So that work objects is data that gets stored into the tables which are under data schema. And coming to property, section, flow action and all, look at here. Suppose here you go. Here you see hyperlink, customer, manager and all. You click on this hyperlink. This is a hyperlink in HTML. Property is open. So this property is a rule. This property, when I click on hyperlink, how it has been opened? Suppose once you create a property, when you create a property, data model, any rule you create. Now it has been created. It is getting created and it has been created now. So I'm going to close this. So this is the data inside this property. I'm going to close this. Just let me refresh it and open again. When I click on this hyperlink, it has opened. Okay. So whenever you are creating exactly, sorry, whenever I click on this property, it is bringing up something and displaying it to you. So where it is bringing up from? It is bringing up from the backend database. Property that you have created, when you create it, it is getting stored into backend, into one of the table. We are not required to bother about which table as of now. I'll tell you in some time. Now, property that you have created, section which you have created, flow actions, flows, and number of rules that you have created so far. Everything has been stored into backend database. Okay. Apart from your work objects are getting stored into work table, properties will get stored into one of the tables. Suppose if you create 10 properties, there will be a table for properties. Properties table name is PR4 underscore properties. In the table, how many records will be there? 10 records will be there. One record is equal to one property. So each rule that you are creating will occupy space in the database in one of the table. So anytime you create a property, property will get stored into some table. You create section, that section will get stored into some table. The hyperlinks will be displayed to you here in the classes. When you click on the hyperlink, what happens is internally there is a query that gets executed. This is going to query the actual table, properties table, and bring up the property. If you click on hyperlink of the section, suppose here you go, user interface, section. So click on this. This is just a hyperlink. When you click on this hyperlink, section has been opened and it is being displayed. Now on click of this, what is happening internally? It is going to query the table. Because you clicked on section, it is going to query the table where your sections are getting stored, and it is going to bring the instance on which you have clicked. Okay, exactly that record will be fetched, pulled, and displayed to you in the UI. You just do modification and then save. It will again going to get updated in the backend. First time when you are creating, it is an insert query. And then when you are trying to click on the link, it is a select query. And whenever you are going to modify and then save, it is going to be an update query. If you click on delete, that record from the actual table will be deleted. So Pega is all about database. You're not required to be expert in database. It's a minimum thing. Okay. That means anything that is flowing in this PRPC will be there in the backend. On PRPC environment, anything you see, application you have created, right? Application is a role. Application is also a role. Application will get stored into backend. Now, here when I click on this hyperlink and choose definition, it is going to run a query, select query on which table, application related table, and the specific application which I am trying to open will be opened and displayed. The data will be pulled from there and it has been displayed in the UI here. Okay, so all that you create in Pega will get stored into backend database, that we call it as rule base. Anything you create will get stored into backend database, that is called as rule base. Rule base has been divided with two schemas. One is data and the other one is rules. All the rules which we create will get stored into rules table, that is called rule instances, we call it as, and all data instances. For example, as of now, part of this one is work object. All work objects we have already seen is getting stored into data schema related tables. So far we did not access this rule schema anytime. Look at here, rules, and here you go with tables and scroll down, PR4 underscore PR4 underscore rule underscore section. If you see this table will have a number of records because it is not the only sections that we have created so far. Pega has already many predefined user interface rules. Any section that you create should be available in this table. Okay, so you create 10 sections, each section is equal to one record in this table. Okay, when you click on hyperlink there, this table will be fetched and the data will be displayed in UI. In which format the data gets stored? Blob format, because everything in Pega will get stored into blob format in PJET PV stream column. Okay, so some of the things are there which will be normal columns. I have told you few of the columns among those, that is PX create date time, PX update date time, PX create operator, PX update operator. For work object we have seen that. For sections also, do we have the same PX create date time, PX update date time, PX update operator, create operator will be there for section property, everything. Anything you create in Pega, it must be created by some operator. It must be updated by some, maybe it might have been updated last by some operator. It must have a create date time. It must have update date time. So these four are as of now generic columns. Okay, we'll talk about more generic columns sometime later. So like this, Pega is going to maintain everything in its database. So Pega is all about database, storing in database, bringing up from the database, etc. Installation of, suppose you have done your development here, you wanted to move the rules which you have created here in this environment into another server, another machine. That means you are going to take records from the database and then you are inserting records at the other database. That's it. Front end is for accessing this front end is for accessing the Pega rules database. Everyone clear? So Pega is all about creating something in database, getting something pulled from the database, and what else, storing something into database and modifying something within database. All these four queries will frequently gets executed. Create, update, that is what, insert, update, delete, and then select queries. Okay, so now here you go, this is rule base has two schemas. One is rule schema, data schema. Rules get stored into rule schema, data gets stored into data schema. And all the data about anything, I mean like if it is a rule or data, work object data will be in blob format. Rule data will be there in blob format in a generic column. What is the column? PJET PV stream. That means for every table in Pega rule base, you'll be having that column, PJET PV stream, which will have the data about that particular, the information about that particular rule instance or data instance. Okay, I will tell you about data instances again later. Okay, but as of now, this is basic idea. Let me go ahead and write down the same. Everyone clear with this? Role base.
I'm sorry, I'm having the doubt.
Chapand, what is the doubt?
So when we are, when you are selecting the data from the database table, just you are giving the view 100 rows or something like that. So can we give the any selection conditions for fetching the rows from the database?
Can you please be a little bit louder?
I mean, what I'm asking is like, when you are selecting the records from the database table, can we give any specific conditions?
Can we give any?
Specific conditions in the select query.
We can give no problem. That is, the internal is okay. Create, who created, only some of the operator created rules. Like you can give any where condition, no issues. And two schemas from Pega 7. Before Pega 7, we used to have Pega rule base as only one schema. So before, if you go to before Pega 7 applications, Pega 6 and before versions, we do not have two schemas. Means rules and data, everything will be there in tables. The tables will be there in only one single schema. At later point of time, they have divided. So what is the reason they have divided? We'll be learning later. The way of having two schemas architecture is called as split schema architecture. This notes document is not available, so this is called as split schema architecture. I'll talk more about split schema architecture maybe at the end of the classes again. Now, any rule which we create, like what are the rules? Properties, sections, flow actions, flows, applications, what else? When rules, inka, etc. Get stored into tables under which schema? Rules schema. Under rule schema. Data instances. Example, as of now, okay, I'll write down. As of now, I'll write down operator. But you don't know about this. What are these you are not aware of? I'll be explaining you while we are discussing about operators and all. I'll give you like data instances, work objects, comma, these one and etc. I'm going to mention. Get stored into data schema tables. Okay, so rules get stored into rules schema, data gets stored into data schema. This is called split schema architecture. Information about rule or data gets stored in which format? Blob format into the column. What is the column name? Pjet PV stream. That means every table in rule base will have a common column. There are many common columns. This is one of the main common column. Common column, what is that? Pjet PV stream. So any table you go and check, this column will be there. Other than this, you will be having PX create date time, PX update date time, create operator, update operator, and Pjet INSK. One more column is there, which we'll be learning later. Okay. So this is the information about what is there in the database. Now coming to specific instances, property. So I have asked you, right, whenever I have shared the documents to you about property, section, flow, action, flow, there is one of the point, that is property is an instance of class. What is the class? Rule object property. Section is an instance. It was written like this. I have asked you to ignore reading that point as of now. Now you can go back and read it. I will be explaining the same. Okay. So the property which you have created is getting stored into backend database, right? Now the work object which you have created is getting stored into backend table. Leave about schemas. Only we'll discuss about table now. See, work object which you have created is getting stored into backend table. Now if I click on this class name, what is happening? These are all work objects which we have created. These are all work objects, are these are all instances of this particular class group. If you click on hyperlink here, this class name, single click, these are work objects of this class group. So work object is an instance of class group. This is what we have discussed. That means when you single click on any class name, it is going to display instances of that particular class name, that particular class. That means no need to go to backend and see. Here itself it will display. If you single click on abstract class, then is it going to display any instances? It will not display anything, because abstract classes will not be connected back to tables, will not be having tables. It is not only these classes. Look at here, role dash obj dash property. This is one of the class available in Pega, OTB class. I am going to single click on this class. Now instances of this class have been displayed. Instances of property. What are these? PV claims, claim reason, claim amount, prior claim, personal vehicle. All these are first name, last name, manager, customer, gender, state, city. What are these? These are all the properties which we have created. These are all properties which we have created. So every property that we have created so far, apart from OTB properties in Pega, every property that we have created has been stored into backend table. The table data, if I wanted to see, the table name is PR4 underscore operators. Generally, we'll go to backend and all. But without going to backend, if I single click on the class name, it is displaying the data. That means rule obj property class, it is been mapped to the table in which properties are getting stored. If you wanted to see that, what is the navigation? Mapping rule. I mean, like database table class mapping rule. If you want to see, what is the navigation? Right click, view. Yeah, you can go to definition. In the definition,
test connection.
Okay, you can do that. No problem. So here you go. Definition. If you go to the definition of the class, scroll down. Test connection to table. You have this option only available for what type of classes? We have abstract classes, concrete classes. Suppose if you open abstract class and see, do you find this test connection to table? It will not be there, because abstract classes will not have any instances. When there are no instances, no need to store into backend. So no need of backend table connections and all. Only concrete classes will have instances. That means every rule that you are creating will get stored into one of the table, which will be connected back to one of the concrete class, which might not be class group. Class group is only when in case of your transactions. Okay. Now here you go, test connection to table. Click on this test connection to table. What is the table name? This is the table name, PR4 underscore rule underscore property. So now any property which you create in any class in Pega, throughout Pega BRPC, not only Hanover application, you created 2-3 applications. There are different classes available. Anywhere in PRPC environment, if you create property, that property is going to get stored into backend in one table. Okay, that is PR4 underscore rule underscore property. So property is an instance of class rule obj property, meaning that the properties you create will get stored into a table which is mapped to rule obj property class. That is the meaning of the statement. Property is an instance of class rule obj property. That means the properties which we create will get stored into a table which is mapped to the class rule obj property. Similarly, section is an instance of class rule dash HTML dash section. Section is an instance of class rule HTML section. What does that mean? Any section which you create in Pega BRPC environment will get stored into backend table. So that table will be mapped to which class? Rule HTML section class. If I wanted to see the table where sections get stored, I have to go to rule dash HTML dash section, select this, and then right click on it, and then choose to go to definition, scroll down, click on test connection. You will see section is getting stored into PR4 underscore rule underscore section. I will talk about the prefixes in few minutes from now. Everyone clear? After we create our own table, I'll talk about it. Now PR4 underscore rule underscore section. Sections are getting stored into one dedicated table called PR4 underscore rule underscore section. Like that, every role which you create, flow action. Flow action is an instance of class role dash obj dash flow action. This is there in your document. Now right click on this and go to definition and then choose to click on test connection. When I click on test connection, PR4 underscore rule. The name is just simply PR4 underscore rule. That's how Pega is maintained. So properties get stored into table 1. Sections get stored into table 2. Flow actions getting stored into table 3. It can be any name, different tables. So property is an instance of class rule obj property, meaning that any property you create gets stored into a table. We are not required to bother about table names at all in PRPC generally. If you know class name, you can do anything. Okay, finding out table name is very easy when you know class name. Without knowing class name, you cannot find the table names. That will be difficult. Okay, so we need to always remember class names. Okay, all tables will be referred with class names only. Property is an instance of class rule dash obj dash property. So properties get stored into one of the table in the backend, which is mapped to rule obj property class. And section is an instance of class rule HTML section. So sections are getting stored into a table, any table. It can be one of the table which is mapped back to class rule HTML section. Similarly, flow action is an instance of class rule obj flow action. Flow is an instance of class rule obj flow. These respective rules will get stored into the respective tables which are mapped back to classes rule obj flow action and rule obj flow accordingly. Everyone clear? This is the information that I wanted to give you. Let me not write down the same. Every rule that we create everyone clear with this gets stored into rule based tables. It is going to get stored into rule based table. Properties get stored into table PR4 underscore rule underscore. What is the property? What is the property? Sections get stored into table PR4 underscore rule underscore. What is that? Section. Flow actions get stored into table. What is the table name? PR4 underscore rule underscore rule. I'm sorry, PR4 underscore rule. That's it. This is the table. Similarly, you can find. See, this is my knowledge. So how do you know? As a developer, suppose you don't have access to database and all. This is the first time that you are doing. You have access to only PRPC environment if you wanted to find out. So this is most important. So property is an instance of class OTP class. What is the class name? Property is an instance of which class? Rule dash obj dash property. That means every property gets stored into a table which is mapped to its instance class. This is the meaning. Okay, now its instance class PR4 underscore, what is that? Rule underscore property is the table which is mapped to class rule dash obj dash property. Okay, suppose if you want to see this, designer studio means developer studio. Designer studio, what we can do, we used to call it as designer studio in previous version, now it is developer studio. Now what you have to do here, rule obj property, you just type here and then right click on this and then definition. Now we are trying to understand PRPC's OOTP design, how it is available. That is what we are trying to achieve. So you need to scroll down and click on test connection. So here in this document, in this screenshot, you can see it has been mapped to br4 underscore role underscore property table. Similarly, you can verify for all the other roles. Done. Similarly, what about the other text which I have written? Table names. Is it there or I have removed it? It is there, right? Similarly, we can find the same for any other role when we know its instance class. When we know its instance class, just simply search for instance class, open the definition, scroll down, and then click on test connection. You will be able to know the name. Okay, this is clear, everyone. Now we had come across with table names PC underscore work table, and this is PR4 underscore something. There is a prefix PC, here it is PR4. There is another prefix also available, which I will tell you. All these prefixes I will explain you in few minutes. Okay. Okay. So this is about rule base. Rule base is going to have two schemas. One is data schema and rule schema. Simply rules get stored into rule schema tables, data gets stored into data schema tables, out of which we have seen few tables. Now let's go ahead and talk about, suppose if you wanted to create a table, so how to create. So before we proceed to that, in general, in any technology, it's not related to technology, it's related to database. In any business, for your business, suppose if you are trying to design database, okay, you have designed your own database and you have created tables in that. So in any database of any business, we'll be having two types of tables. Tables will be classified into two types. Those who are already working on any technology, you should be able to tell me this. Others, try to listen and learn now. What was that? What are the two types of tables?
Master tables and transaction tables.
One is master table, someone saying online. Master tables, or you call it as reference tables. Anything is okay. And the second one is transaction tables, or you call it as business tables. There are two types of, it is irrespective of Pega, it is generic. Okay. So there will be two types of tables available in any business. One is master table or reference table. Second one is transaction table and business table. Let me tell you an example. Suppose if you are going to create a bank account, okay, and after you get the bank account and all, you will be making some transactions in the bank. The data that flows while you perform transactions is transaction data. That means you deposit money, that is one transaction. So the details related to that money deposit transaction is called transaction data, out of which the main thing is the amount which you are going to deposit. Okay. And other one is, like, suppose if you withdraw money, you do third party transfer, you pay bills, like this, all this is different types of transactions. The data related to those transactions is transaction data. And bank will maintain details about branches. Bank will have a number of branches, right? Okay. While you are performing transactions from one, let's say one account to another account you are sending. So your account belongs to so and so branch. So while you are performing these transactions, during the transactional processing, it has to get some data about which branch this account belongs to. And then it is going to send amount to other account. That time also it has to get the data about which branch the third party account belongs to, which bank and which branch and all. See, now branch details will be maintained inside banking database. Apart from your transaction data of what you are just processing, branch names, branch codes, everything has to be maintained in the database. Anytime when you perform any transaction, will there be any impact on the branch tables? That means when you perform a transaction, your transaction details, suppose if you download this, what do you call it as, statement. That statement is one record is equal to one transaction which you have performed. So the table, there will be a backend table. The table data will get modified every time when you perform a transaction. The total amount of balance that you should have, everything will get modified. Each time when you perform a transaction, the table data gets modified. So that is transaction data. So that is transaction table. Transaction table means which gets impacted while you perform transactions. So now similarly, there will be a table which is holding branch codes and branch names. Will there be any impact on the branch codes, branch name table when you perform any transaction? There won't be any impact. It is just going to pull the data. It will not perform any insert. It will not perform any update. It will not perform any delete on the tables. But your transaction tables gets impacted for each transaction that you do. It may do update, it may do insert, it may do delete accordingly. Okay, it depends. Now transaction tables are the ones which gets impacted for every transaction when you perform transactions. Master table or reference tables are just holding some reference data which can be pulled and used during the transactional process. If you want to update reference data, who will update that? Business will update from their end. Accordingly, they will maintain some tools in order to make the data entry into business table. Master tables. Master tables will not get updated as you perform the transactions. Master tables will be manually updated, or somehow they will be using some tools to update the master data in the databases. Okay, like this, there will be a number of tables like this. Okay, suppose you are performing a transaction. Suppose you are going to initiate an insurance processing transaction. As part of insurance processing, there are certain documents required. Insurance processing is one transaction. The documents required for this transaction will be pulled from one of the table. The table will have driving license required, and then employee, salary slip is required, previous bank statement is required. All that information about this transaction, what is needed, what type of documents will be pulled from database table, and it will be displayed to you in the UI where you can click on that and then upload the required documents there. Now this is constant data forever. Maybe it will change sometimes. Sometimes if bank has come up with any of the modifications in the processing, we need one more additional document called Aadhaar card going forward. They will update the table, that updated data will be pulled into UI and it will also prompt you for uploading the Aadhaar card. Like this, they will directly update the tables using some user interfaces and all. So that data of document IDs and document names, which will be maintained in the backend, will not get updated or inserted or deleted when you perform any of the transactions. Okay, that is called reference data or master data, and transaction updated data is called as transaction data, and those tables are called as transaction tables. So we'll be having these two types of tables, transaction tables and reference tables. Everyone clear? This is not only related to Pega, it is very general. Okay, now here you go. So in Pega, now I have work object table, right? PC underscore, generically I call it as work table or work tables. That is framework work table, implementation work tables. Just tell me, are those transaction tables or reference tables? Those are transaction tables. When you create a work object, you open work object and modify or delete work object, those tables get, each work object is equal to one transaction, right? So those are transaction tables. Any tables which gets impacted as part of the work object processing, those table names will start with PC underscore. Those tables will name will start with PC underscore. That is how Pega has come up with the design. Any tables which are meant for reference data, as of now we did not create, we'll be creating. Those are going to start with the name PR underscore. Just PR underscore. There is another category of table in Pega, that is PR4 underscore. What are those tables? PC underscore transaction tables. Example, work object tables, plus there will be document tables, there will be another assignment tables also involves. We'll discuss about other tables later, as of now, work object tables. PR tables we did not create, that is reference tables, master tables. And now tell me, what is that? This table? PR4 tables. Rules will get stored into PR4 tables. All the rules that you create will get stored into a table. Into tables, those names starts with PR4. That is how database table names are being categorized to have prefixes of PC underscore, PR underscore, PR4 underscore. Everyone clear with this? That is the naming convention. I have a separate document available for this, which I will share you. The one which I have told now, PC tables, PR tables, PR4 tables, I have already a separate document available which I'll share you. Everyone clear with this? You understand now? Now if you go to data schema, rule schema, any table that you see there, either it must be starting with PC underscore or BR underscore or BR4 underscore. Now we have some other table naming conventions. Leave about it. That is not required. That is special tables. Leave it. Okay. If you find a table name starting with PC, that will be impacted during the processing of work object. If you find a table name PR underscore, that means it is a reference table, constant data for long time. Okay. And if you find a table with PR4 underscore, definitely rules will get stored into the respective rules get stored into that particular table. Everyone clear with this? I will share you another document for the same. You got this understanding, right? Anyone have any questions in this? Anything you did not understand, let me know. This is all for your information of understanding Pega rules process come under database and its design. Okay. Now let's go ahead. And without knowing this, you should not be working on Pega. These are basic fundamental things one should know if you are a Pega developer. Okay. Now, data types. We're going to talk about data type. This is our next topic. How to create tables. That means reference tables. Generally, transaction tables in Pega are not required to be created because when you create application classes, class groups, transaction work object tables are getting created. Mapping maybe you do or it will be automatically done. Your work object data storing, you are not required to much bother about because PRPC is taking care of it and storing it into work table in a column called PZPV stream in which format? Binary large objects format. So no need to bother about transaction as of now. And now let's talk about, suppose in my application, from application to application, reference tables will be different, right? So document IDs table might not be used for every transaction, for every application. Suppose your transactional processing, which you are designing as part of your business, does it have any document IDs, document names to be pulled, then document table is required, otherwise it is not required. So for every application which you are creating in your enterprise application development, definitely as per the business, there will be some reference tables that will be available. If you wanted to create reference table in Pega, you will be creating those as data types. You'll be creating as data type. Everyone clear with this? Now, see, let me log into existing application and show you that. Another point is, suppose if you have a table, you wanted to access the content from the table in PRPC. So then that means how would you access? You don't need table names. Instead, what you need? Suppose you wanted to access the content from a table, which is there in rule base. You don't need table name at all. So then what you need? Class name. It's mapping class name is required. That means every table in PRPC environment will have one mapping class in the front end. Okay. If you are accessing this class, means you are accessing the table. So table is there, class is there, and mapping rule is there. These three are common. Then what about properties comparison? Property is equal to, suppose property in a class, if you compare with backend table, what it is? I'm asking about, suppose you have a class called work class. This is work class. Okay. There is a table called work table. Work class and table mapping is there. Work class has some property, right? Some properties. If you compare this class with table, you are comparing class is equal to table. There is a mapping available. Now, if you compare property, property is equal to one column in the table. Each column in the table is equal to one property here in the class. And data about means work object. That is data. Data is equal to one record in the table. Okay. Each record is equal to one work object, right? That is what data. So data in the table is equal to one work object. So if you compare PRPC environment, what we have created so far with backend, class is equal to table, property is equal to, means property in specific class is equal to column of the connected table. Okay, you'll be getting understanding of this after we create now. Let's go ahead and let me show you. So here you go. Let me log into existing application and show you. Dev Studio. So here I go with. Okay, I have one table called agency details. It can be any table, no worries. Let me show you. Okay, leave it. I'll show you another table called states. I have a table called states. See, suppose if you are going to register in a Facebook, okay, application. When you are registering, you will be asked to enter the, choose the country name or state name, something like that, right? That will be a drop down. Means list of states will be loaded into drop down from backend. Backend in a table, list of states will be defined, and then that will be loaded into drop down. You'll choose one of the state, okay, as part of the processing. Now that states data which is there in the backend table, that is called reference data, because states will not be getting changed when you make the transaction. It is fixed for some time. Okay. Now here you go. This is how a table can be created in Pega. This is the front end view. For the same, you'll have backend. This one in the backend, how it will be available? Can you tell me? It's the same format. It will be available in backend. In which format? It should be available in blob format in your enterprise application development for sure. What you see here in front end, you cannot see the same in backend because it will be there in blob. Now, states table, if you want to create, you will go to data type, and then you are going to choose add a data type. So here in Pega, data type is equal to a table. Table when I say class. Okay, data type is equal to one table. Data type in other programming languages is related to variables. Variable is associated with a data type, but in Pega, data type means it's a class type table with storage. Storage can be there. Storage means this is storage. Okay. So now here you go. If you create a data type, in a data type, you will be having properties, state code, state name. This, what is this wizard? You are aware of this wizard? The wizard, what you see here on the front end now. What is this wizard? Create properties wizard. Means when you create a data type, you are adding properties into that. That means that is equal to data type columns, state code, state name. If you compare with tables, it is columns, and this is data. These are all instances of this particular class. This is data. Each record is equal to one instance of states class. Now this is map. Okay, now let me open the table class record. Scroll down. Click on test connection. So this is mapped in the back end to which table? PR underscore HDFC underscore data underscore states here. You are not required to bother about the specific naming convention here. You are not needed to bother about PR underscore. This is reference table. I'll tell you how to create it. When this table is created, when this data type is created, it has created a physical table in the backend and mapping has been done. But while PRPC is creating the table, it has taken the naming convention as PR underscore. Reason being, this is a reference table. If you want to create reference tables in PRPC environment, you need to go to data types. From data types, you need to go to add a new data type. Data type is nothing but it is going to be a table with storage. Data storage, we call it as. Storage means records of the table, rows of the table. Everyone clear? So now let me show you. Just tomorrow we'll be creating practically. For example, suppose if I have to show you, add a new data type. Name of the data type, test. This is the name. Okay. And click on this one. So anytime you are creating data classes, vehicle class, claims class, we created under data class, OTB, sorry, data class. Okay. Similarly, your tables also can be created under data classes only. I am creating this under organization data class. Okay. Organization data class, once I choose here as a parent class, what I have got? Class name HDFC data test. That means as part of this table creation, we'll be getting a class created. What is the name of the class? HDFC hyphen data hyphen test. Create, submit this. This is just for testing. But hang on. This instance already exists. Huh? Test one. We'll take test one. Submit this. Means this table might be already available. Now here you go. So when I create test one, it is asking, so when you create a table, what it class? Column names class. Columns and names are nothing but properties. Let's say property. Okay, I'll give like this. Column one, add field. Column two, like this. I'm giving these are properties. You already aware of this wizard. If you are entering something in this wizard, that will create a property. Go to records. Configure, so just for your information, I'm configuring storage as of now, I have created table and then defined columns. And now I am defining storage. While defining storage, you are going to choose one of the column as key column. It can be any column, one or more columns also possible. This is one of the key column and then submit. Real time will not create this. Business analyst will create or tech leads will create. Maybe you will create if you are being given with chance. That is less chances. Maybe you will create once or twice in your career. I'm not pretty much sure even that. And here you go. Column one is, I'll give like value one. This is V1. ID is V1 and V2 value two. This is data. Column one, column two are properties, and HDFC data test one is class. Now, if you go to App Explorer, HDFC data, data test one. Class is created automatically. This is just now when as part of this wizard of data type, class is created, and you see properties available. Leave about other rules. We'll talk about only these property one, property two. I mean column one, column two. And right click on this class. Single click on the class, you got instances. That means these are backend records. Right click on the class and go to definition. Scroll down and test connection. Test connection. Once you do, you got a table created HDFC data test one, and it is starting with PR underscore. And apart from that, this is a concrete class. Concrete class is the only one which can have instances, right? And you see here, does not belong to class group. What do you mean by this? It is not there in the inheritance. So HDFC data test one, is it there in the inheritance path for the class group? It is not connected with inheritance. So PRPC has automatically taken it as does not belong to class group, which we have manually done while we are manually creating a class. Okay. So now this wizard of data type can be used in order to create reference tables in your business. All reference tables that you create will have naming convention starting with the prefix PR underscore. When you create a data type as a reference table, what are the rules that gets created? Class will be created, which is a concrete class, does not belong to class group, and it will create properties. It will create and storage you can add. It will create a physical table in the backend. Apart from these, few other rules gets created, which we will discuss later, not now. Everyone clear with this? If you are being given with requirement to create any of the reference tables, you need to use the wizard of data type. You need to go to data types explorer and then add it. Mostly this task will be taken care by business analyst or by your tech leads. Okay, but here we have to do and we have to work by ourselves, create by ourselves and work on it as well. Everyone clear with this? So did you get the clear idea about what is the reference? This navigations I'll give you in a document later. This is just I have shown you for not explain. Tomorrow we'll be doing this practically. So now by this class, you should have clear idea about what is meant by reference table, what is meant by transaction table. In any technology, any business, these two will be there. Additional to these two, Pega will have one more type of table, that is rules table. That is rules table. PC tables are transaction tables. PR tables are reference tables. PR core tables are rules tables. Whenever you wanted to create any reference table in Pega, you have to go to data types and click on add data type and create. While creating, you need to make sure that you are creating under data classes only. That is the naming, that is the convention that everyone follows. Your tables should be created under data class. That can be organization data class, that can be implementation data class, that can be framework data class based on your business need. This is clear. If you are creating it from data class, means it is ultimately inheriting from data dash. Data dash is ODB class. Okay, this is clear, everyone. So data types can have data storage. Data storage means records. Okay, so we'll work on the practical tomorrow. Everyone clear with this? Just provided information. I'll send you two documents today. One is the one which I have prepared today, and the other one is find out. Hang on. Hey, that is not completed, right? Okay. I'll take it forward after we complete this. No worries. Tomorrow I'll share that rule sets and all. Once I complete that, I'll share that. I thought it is completed. Okay, now what's PR4 tables and all, right? This one, this document, understanding table name prefixes. Okay, so PC trans, this is just for your information. That's it. Transaction tables, PR, these are like master tables or reference tables. PR4, these are like rule related tables. All rules get stored into PR4 tables. I'll share you these two documents. 571 now. Change database. You have environment, right? You can, if you can write any commands, that will get executed. You can drop, delete anything you can. PRBC environment is delete cheyalante. You have to go to backend and delete it. What is the other one? 571, November 7th. Okay, data type document should I have to provide you now.
Harsha, if the work table needs to be deleted, how can we do that?
If you want to delete a table, you go to PG admin environment, right click on the table and then delete it. Done.
Okay.
Or you write a command like query and all, delete table from so on so database.
Okay. I cannot do it through the UI.
PRBC, no. You can delete classes and all, but not tables. That is not recommended actually.
Okay.
So we have a wizard available. Just hang on, I'll show you. Refactor roles. Okay, classes or something. I'm sorry. System refactor classes. Rename a class, delete a class. So here you go. You can choose what is the class that you wanted to delete, and then before you delete the class, make sure all the roles available in that class should be deleted. And then once you run this wizard giving the class name and all, then it should be able to delete class mapping rules. Maybe backend table also will get deleted, but we will never use this.
So inside database option, Harsha, there may be some option to delete table possibly.
There may
inside
be some
the option to delete the table as well. So in the application,
it depends wizard, on the client. So you will not be given with access to delete anything in enterprise application. You will be given only with select access.
Okay.
Bits up. That is completely different. That is reporting, extraction, transmission, loading, business intelligence tool. That is not at all required. Okay, this is clear. So you completely going through these two documents and access the DB environment using PGSQL, Postgres PG4 admin, PGAdmin 4, and then see the table name prefixes and all. We'll be coming across with many of the PC tables, PR tables going forward. You can wind up for today. We'll continue tomorrow. Thank you for joining.